Otomycosis seems very simple, but this is one of the commonest diagnoses you get in an ENT OPD. Oto means something related to ear, and mycosis is fungal infection. So, otomycosis is defined as an acute fungal infection of the external auditory canal. Invasive fungal infection of the temporal bone is not included along with the otomycosis. So, otomycosis is only an acute fungal infection of the external auditory canal, and this constitutes about 10% of the external otitis. What are the commonest organisms? Infection by Aspergillus niger and also Candida albicans. And the commonest is Aspergillus niger followed by Candida albicans. Intense pruritus is the most common complaint. So the patient will scratch the ear using hairpins, safety pin or matchstick, etc. etc. So that will lead to the patient may scratch, leading to pain in the ear, then ringing in the sensation in the ear, fullness in the ear, or the fungal debris collected will lead to discharge from the ear. Discharge will be characteristically of different colors. It can be either watery discharge or greenish in color or blackish discharge. And because of all these, there will be hearing problems also. And on examination, because of inflammation, there will be redness of the external auditory canal skin. The skin will be very flaky. Sometimes there will be external auditory canal edema. And this fungal debris will show the characteristic features of Aspergillus niger or Candida, which is like this. The fungal infection of the external auditory canal has got typical findings on examination. This black mold or the black spore you can see very well in a case of Aspergillus niger. And this appearance is called salt and pepper appearance. Salt and pepper appearance, or it can be a wet newspaper like appearance. This is very typical of Aspergillus, salt and pepper or wet newspaper appearance. In case of Candida infection, see, this is a cotton wool like fluffy appearance or whitish cotton wool like appearance, or it can be a also called a curdy white appearance, and this is typical of Candida albicans infection. So salt and pepper in Aspergillus and curdy white appearance in Candida infection. People living in hot and humid climate, there is a predisposition for getting otomycosis. Then presence of wax in the ear, frequent instrumentation of the ear. Some people have got the habit of cleaning the external auditory canal with earbuds. So that will lead to, there is a chance of otomycosis getting in these patients. Overuse of eardrops, particularly the antibiotic or steroid preparations. Immunocompromised patients and patients with having uncontrolled and long-term diabetes mellitus. Then patients with open cavity, mastoid cavities, and also patients using hearing aid, especially with the occlusive ear mold. Diagnosis is easy because of typical history and examination finding. If any doubt, do a potassium hydroxide preparation and you will see branching filaments or budding yeast. The treatment is, the first and foremost is removal of the fungal debris. Do a suction clearance or dry mopping to remove the complete fungal debris, and after that pack the ear with ointments. Which ointments can be used? You can use either an M-crisyl acetate or 1% clotrimazole ointment or solution, and in resistant cases you can use 1% amphotericin B ointment. But in any case, remember to remove the fungal debris completely and ear packing with the ointment, cream or solution, and never use ear drops directly, because the moisture in the ear canal will again stimulate the growth of fungal debris and the situation will be worsened. So always remember to debride the ear thoroughly, make the ear dry, and also another advantage of using this ear packing is that the ear canal edema will be reduced and the patient will be symptomatically much better. There is high chance of recurrence even after proper treatment. So advise the patient to avoid entry of water into the ear, especially while swimming and surfing. Dry ear after showering. Avoid putting cotton swabs into the ear and also frequent scratching the ear with cotton buds or other materials like safety pin. Then also strict control of diabetes mellitus is needed. This can also lead to complications. One of the main complications is multiple perforations of the tympanic membrane, which later on can lead to chronic suppurative otitis media. And also this condition as such can acute infection, fungal infection can change into chronic infection. So the two main MCQs which are asked from this otomycosis, one is the commonest organism causing this is Aspergillus niger followed by Candida albicans, and it can also cause multiple tympanic membrane perforation.